Hello everyone, today I am going to talk on protein sorting, trafficking as well as targeting mechanism, which is a part of module 1.7. See, as we know, protein synthesis occurs in the cytoplasm. Protein synthesis occurs either on free ribosome or bonded ribosome. Bonded ribosomes are nothing, these are the ribosomes which are bound on or which are associated with endoplasmic reticulum, commonly called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Whether protein is synthesized in the free cytoplasm or in the cytoplasm, or it is synthesized in rough endoplasmic reticulum, these proteins are having certain destination. As we know, proteins are required by cell organelles, all cell organelles, cell membrane, and sometimes this protein need to be excreted out, or we can say they are secreted out. It means proteins are required everywhere. It means whatever the protein is synthesized in the cytoplasm as well as in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, they should reach to the particular destination. For the transport of protein or translocation of protein to the particular translocation, some specific signal molecule must be required. These signal molecules or signal peptides are nothing, they are the small sequence which is not a part of particular protein. It's a separate type, separate peptides, but they are actually deciding where this protein should be translocated. Say for example, protein synthesized in cytoplasm that can be translocated to the nucleus, that can be translocated to the peroxisome, that can be translocated to the cell membrane or mitochondria, etc. Where protein will be translocated, it is all decided by signal peptides. There are different type of signal peptide. We'll talk on signal peptides later on in this slide only. Here, we are trying to understand what is protein targeting or what is protein sorting. Protein targeting or protein sorting is the mechanism by which a cell transport protein, those protein which are produced either in the free cytoplasm by free ribosomes, or protein which is synthesized in the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now this protein will translocate from the particular site, that is synthesis site, to the target site. That process is known as protein targeting, or it is also known as protein sorting. Let's see in detail about the protein translocation. See, protein synthesized, suppose protein is synthesized in the cytoplasm. Let us start how protein are actually translocated from one location to other. There are three ways of the transport of protein. First, gated transport. If protein which is synthesized in the cytoplasm, they will transport from cytoplasm to the nucleus, this is called gated transport. It may be vice versa. It means it may be possible that protein synthesized in the cytoplasm may be translocated to the nucleus, or sometimes this protein can be reverted back to the cytoplasm. These all are part of gated transport. Second is transmembrane transport. As I have shown in the diagram in the blue structure, you can observe. If protein is produced in the cytoplasm and it can be translocated to the peroxisome, plastids, mitochondria as well as itself endoplasmic reticulum, this is known as transmembrane transport. And third type of transport is known as vesicular transport, which involves vesicle. Basically, vesicles are formed from endoplasmic reticulum, then it will pass to the Golgi body, as I have already shown in this diagram. From this Golgi body, they may be a part of secretory vesicles. These vesicles are secreted protein outside the cell, so it will be transported outside the cell. It may be possible that these vesicles will fuse to the plasma membrane. Hence, protein which is required in the plasma membrane, they are also formed in the endoplasmic reticulum, then they modify in the Golgi body, and finally, they will be part of plasma membrane. Some proteins are secreted outside also. As we know how lysosomes are formed, basically lysosomes are formed from endosomes. There are two type of endosome, one is early and second is late endosome. Usually early endosomes are formed from cell surface, and these early endosomes are converted into late endosomes. The conversion of late endosome to the lysosome are depend on certain enzymes. All these enzymes or protein are actually transported to the late endosome by Golgi body. In short, the protein which is formed in the endoplasmic reticulum will be transferred to the Golgi body. From Golgi body, it is transported to the late endosome. When all the enzymes will be present in the late endosome, it is now converted into lysosome structure. This is also a part of vesicular transport. Now, there are two paths. We have already gone through that particular part. So, there are two paths. One is co-translational and second is post-translational translocation. First is, what is co-translational translocation? Translocation, you know, transfer of protein from one location to other. What is co-translational? Let us understand, co, it means simultaneously. Actually, when protein is going to synthesize by the ribosomes in the cytoplasm, some of the protein is not completely synthesized in the cytoplasm itself. When protein synthesis initiated, partial protein is synthesized, then protein synthesis process will be stopped. Now, there are certain translocator proteins. This translocator protein will direct ribosome, mRNA and newly synthesized protein to translocate on rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now, ribosome will bind to rough endoplasmic reticulum, and now complete protein synthesis occurs inside the rough endoplasmic reticulum. This mechanism is called co-translational. Now, after co-translation, whatever protein is produced, they will be produced in rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now, these proteins will be translocated from rough endoplasmic reticulum to the different site. This is called co-translational translocation. Second is post-translational translocation. This is a simple type of mechanism. In this mechanism, protein synthesis occurs in the ribosomes. These are the free ribosomes in the cytoplasm itself. Now, once protein is totally synthesized, the complete synthesis of proteins occurs, then this protein will translocate from cytoplasm to certain organelle. Let's see what are the different organelle where these proteins are transported. Post-translational translocation, the target site is nucleus, mitochondria, chloroplast and peroxisome, whereas co-translational targeting, these are ER, Golgi body, lysosome, plasma membrane and maybe outside the protein, that is secretory proteins. One by one we will cover. As you know, post-translational is a common mechanism. We will first start and focus on co-translational translocation. This mechanism was first hypothesized by Sabatini as well as Blobel in 1971. In this mechanism, you can observe the first part, that is mRNA will bind it with the ribosomes. Now, protein synthesis is initiated. Then you can see the protein synthesis start in the cytoplasm, but it will stop. Later on, signal recognition particle SRP, they will bind to the ribosomes and they translocate ribosome from cytoplasm to the endoplasmic reticulum. They will bind to a particular region that is known as sec protein, or it is also known as translocone. This translocone, as you see in the figure, it is closed. In the third number, you can see it's closed. Then later on, once it is bind properly, it involves GTP hydrolysis. After hydrolysis, SRP will be free, and this SRP will move and they will bind to the other mRNA, or we can say other ribosomes, that is separately. Now, this ribosome along with the mRNA, they bind to the translocone. Now, this translocone will be open and protein which is already synthesized, they can be inserted inside the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. Now, this protein will be actually clipped by signal peptidase. It is present inside the lumen. After cleaving, the protein synthesis will be initiated and total protein will be synthesized in the ER lumen itself. This is co-translational. Now, the protein which is synthesized, they will be transported to some other location, that is called co-translational translocation. There are different type of membrane proteins which are synthesized by the same mechanism, that is co-translational mechanism, but they are having certain type of differences. There are several type of membrane protein topology. These are of 5 types: type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, as well as GPI linked proteins. Let us understand one by one. Type 1, type 2, type 3, these are considered as single pass because they will cross the membrane only single times. Type 4 is known as multipass because they are able to cross the membrane 7 times. It is also known as 7 pass. Now, start with the first one, that is type 1. Type 1, you can observe that C-terminal portion is present in the cytosol. It means in the cytosolic region, C-terminal is present, and in the extracellular exoplasmic space, you can find out N-terminal region. Next, come to the type 2 region. In type 2, N-terminal is located in the cytoplasm. In type 3, you can observe the same thing, that is, C-terminal region is present, but you can observe clear here that C-terminal is present in the cytosol, but still it is different from type 1 in the sense that in the type 1, you will observe a long length of N-terminal region, but here in the type 3, the length is very, very short. So, this is the basic difference between type 1 and type 3. Now, fourth is multipass. As I have already covered in the previous lecture about the G protein coupled receptor, this is part of type 4 G protein coupled receptor glucose transport, ABCA small molecule pumps, etc., 661 voltage gated channels. These all are part of multiple pass or 7 transmembrane receptors. And last one is GPI linked receptor. The example is, since it is GPI linked, the example is plasminogen activator receptor as well as facilisin 2. The example of type 1 is LDL receptor. This all you have gone through. The example of type 1 is LDL, influenza, then type 2 is transferrin receptor, then Golgi, CLIL transferase, etc. That you will see later on. One by one, we will see how this protein will be translocate. Till now, I just told you that how protein is synthesized. Either protein is synthesized in cytoplasm or they are synthesized in endoplasmic reticulum. The mechanism is, one is post-translational, that is translation occurs in the cytoplasm, and second is co-translational, which occurs on endoplasmic reticulum. If protein is synthesized in the free ribosome, it means in the cytoplasm, then this protein will be translocate only if they are having certain signal. If no signal will be present, it means this protein will be remain present in the cytoplasm. Suppose the signal is nuclear localization signal, that is NLS, as the name suggests, nuclear, it means it will translocate to the nucleus, and the mechanism of translocation is gated transport. Next is, if this this protein which is synthesized in the free ribosome, if they contain N-terminal positively charged molecule, it means they will be translocate to the mitochondria via post-translational transmembrane transport mechanism. If signal will be 3 amino acid at C terminal, it means it will be translocated to the peroxisome by the same transmembrane transport process. Now, there is other transport, co-translational transport. As you know that when protein synthesis will is initiated in the co-translational process, the signal molecules or signal peptide will be there. This signal peptide will be directed to the endoplasmic reticulum. This signal peptide is basically hydrophobic amino acid at N terminal. It means in the co-translational process, which I have shown in the previous slide, the protein synthesis initiated in the cytoplasm, then this protein will be finally synthesized in the RER, but how they will transfer from cytoplasm to the RER, it will be transferred by a signal peptide, and this is hydrophobic amino acid. Now, once protein is totally produced in the endoplasmic reticulum, it will be transferred via vesicular transport mechanism. In previous slide, I have shown the same diagram. In that, the protein transferred from or translocate from ER to Golgi, then Golgi to plasma membrane or out of the plasma membrane. It depends on type of protein. Then later on, the protein might be transferred into the late endosome, and through the late endosome, it is once late endosome will be accumulating all this protein, it is now converted into lysosome. Now, I am going to compile whatever I told you. For the compilation, there are two type of process. One is ribosome bound RER and second is free ribosome protein. It means protein is synthesized in two different location. First is ribosome bound, which is co-translational. In that one, as you know that in the diagram you can see ribosomes are there, protein is synthesized. Now, complete protein is synthesizing in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and then it will transfer to the Golgi body, plasma membrane or lysosome, or outside it will be exported out. On the other hand, you can observe free ribosomes. It means protein which are produced in the cytoplasm by free ribosomes, these are transferred to the nucleus, mitochondria, chloroplast, peroxisome, chloroplast, cytoplasm. See, these are shown here in this diagram. They all are translocated to different location. So this is all about protein synthesis as well as translocation. Now we'll talk about vesicular transport. See, as you know, for the vesicular transport, vesicle need to be prepared. For formation of vesicle, it requires coat protein. There are two type of coat protein 1 and coat protein 2. It is also considered as COP1 and COP2. Vesicles are also formed by clathrin. So there are two methods. One is clathrin coated vesicle and second is known as coat protein vesicle. So vesicles are of two types, clathrin coated, again I remind, clathrin coated and COP, that is coat protein coated. Now coat protein are of two types, COP1 and COP2. As you can see in the diagram, basically coat protein, which are of two types, there are distinguished transfer of location. It means all proteins are not translocated by COP1 and COP2. There is a fixed translocation mechanism. You should see in the diagram, in the red which I have shown here, COP2. These vesicles are always transported in the anterograde direction. Anterograde direction, it means endoplasmic reticulum to Golgi body. You should remember that they are those type of direction which are passing from center to the periphery. It means any type of translocation which are arise to the center and pass to the periphery, that is called anterograde, whereas periphery to center is known as retrograde. In the COP2, as you see, it is anterograde type of translocation, and hence vesicle are always transferred from ER to Golgi. Whereas in the case of COP1, you can observe several blue marks. These all are COP1. It is retrograde. So you can see here in the retrograde, this Golgi body, they are actually several compartments of the Golgi body, cis, mid as well as trans. So from trans to mid, mid to cis, as well as the reverse direction, that is cis to trans and trans, cis to mid and mid to trans, these all directions are basically mediated by COP1. In the COP1, it may be possible that this trans vesicle, it means from the trans region of the Golgi, this vesicle will form and it will be responsible for the transport of molecule to the outside of cell. Now see the clathrin. Whatever the diagram I have shown here, in the clathrin coated, you can see it is endocytosis. It means clathrin coated vesicles are related with the endocytosis process. As you know, in the endocytosis process, proteins or any molecules are coming from outside of the cell and finally vesicles are formed. For that, clathrin must be required. Again, see the details, all the things I have written in the word, the same thing in the COP1 coated vesicles, as you have seen in the last diagram. It is from ergic. What is ergic now? Ergic molecule are basically the first molecule which is first type of membrane which is present between the ER and Golgi. So sometimes in the between the ER and Golgi, you can find ergic. It is intermediate compartment situated between the ER and Golgi. So you should remember that proteins, if pass from ergic and Golgi body, and it will come back. I'll again show in the COP1. You can see here. For the COP1, the first molecule compartment is ergic. So ergic to ER or ergic to Golgi body, these all are associated with the COP1. Other is COP2, which I have already told you, it is forward direction. It means from ER to ergic. And the third is clathrin coated, which I have shown in the diagram. It is involved in participation of endocytic pathway. The same I have shown here, but there is a difference between the previous diagram and this one. See, you can see two pathway, forward as well as retrieval pathway. The forward pathway, try to see the diagram clearly. In the first diagram I have shown here that in the endoplasmic reticulum, yellow colored protein is present. This is secretory protein. Secretory protein, it means it need to be secreted outside the cell or it will be the part of plasma membrane. Now this secretory protein, they may be part of lysosome even. This secretory protein, along with the secretory protein, you can see some other protein which is known as resident protein. Resident protein means this protein is not need to be secreted. This is a part of endoplasmic reticulum. But sometimes due to continuous transport of the protein, sometimes it may be possible that along with the secretory protein, this resident protein may be transferred. So first diagram which I have shown here is forward pathway. Actually, only secretory proteins should be transported. In the first diagram which I have shown, the first, that is only secretory, the yellow colored secretory protein is translocated to the ergic. If it is secreted to the ergic, it means the right protein is secreted. But if in the second diagram, see here, in the second diagram, you can see along with the yellow color red part, it means along with the secretory protein, some resident protein is also translocated to the ergic region. Now, it should be retrieved back, because this protein did not need to be secreted out. It should be retrieved back to the ER. The retrieval will be done by certain specific molecules. You can see it is going to be retrieved. This is known as retrieval pathway. Now, finally, it will be retrieved back. Actually, there are certain specific markers like KDL, KKXX. So, these are the certain type of peptides which are present in this retrieval protein. Due to this retrieval only, the retrieval pathway occurs. Along with that, you can see here, certain protein sometimes not retrieved back from ergic to the ER, then later on it will be reversed back from Golgi body to ER. It means if this protein, that means resident protein, will not return back from ergic, it will return back again later on from Golgi, but it will be definitely returned back. It means retrieval pathway occurs. If everything is fine, it means there is no as such retrieval protein is present, it means resident protein is present, then this protein which is marked as yellow here, secretory protein, it will pass to the cis to trans, etc. Now, here you can understand there are two type of secretion. As I already told you in the last diagram, that if everything is fine, the secretory protein from ER will shift to the ergic to the Golgi. In the Golgi, it is cis to mid to the trans. From trans, it will be exported out. There are two type of secretion. One is constitutive secretion, second is known as regulated secretion. Constitutive secretion is a default pathway, it always occurs, and that's why during constitutive secretion, it may be possible that along with the specific secretory protein, certain resident protein might be transported. But in the regulatory type of secretion, they are fixed only specific protein which need to be secreted will be secreted out, and hence it requires signal molecule to translocate from one location to other. So up to here, I'm just I have just covered about the protein formation, protein translocation, as well as different type of pathway. Now certain examples has been shown here. One of the example is for the translocation is translocation to the nucleus. As you see here in the first diagram, the first one which is marked here, the nuclear protein which is covered with the NLS, that is nuclear localization signal, which is marked as red here. This nuclear localization signal itself says that this protein should be enter into nucleus. The help of transferring this molecule from NLS to nucleoplasm will be done by importin, which are of two types, alpha and beta. Now alpha beta will bind to the NLS, that is nuclear localization signal. They will direct this nuclear localization signal as well as nuclear protein to import inside the nucleoplasm. Once it will be enter inside, the RAN protein will have GTP hydrolysis, and finally alpha and beta will be separate, and this nuclear protein along with the NLS, that is nuclear localization signal, will be entered in the nucleoplasm, and finally this molecule, importin molecule, that is alpha and beta, will be reverted back to the cytoplasm so that they can bind with the other nuclear protein, and this type of import will be continuous. The last part which you have to understand here is vesicle budding as well as fusion. As I have already told you that COP1, COP2 as well as clathrin are responsible for the vesicle formation. How this all process occurs and how this vesicle will produce in the particular donor site and it will reach to the acceptor or target site. See, this vesicle budding and transfusion, this requires snare protein. There are two type of snare, V snare and T snare. V stand for vesicular, T stand for target. It means the snare protein which are actually formed, it means in the budding type of vesicles, V snares are present. It means in the vesicle, you can find out V snare, vesicular snare protein, whereas in the target site, you can find T snares. So, you can see here, In the first diagram, initiation process occurs. In the initiation process, the proteins which need to be translocated, these proteins are actually come to the peripheral region. Now, certain other protein known as transmembrane cargo protein, they will bind to the particular cargo protein. Cargo proteins means those protein which need to be translocate from one location to other. Now, this cargo protein will make a vesicle. For vesicle, it needs either coat protein or clathrin. In this example, I have shown coat protein. Suppose coat protein will be there. This coat protein will help in the formation of vesicle. Now, it will be bud off. Budding process occurs. After budding, it will be season. Season means it will be removed from the particular location and they will enter into a particular path. There is a fixed cytoskeleton. Through this cytoskeleton path only, this vesicle is transported from one location to other. Now, after certain time period, there is uncoating process occurs. Due to uncoating, this coat protein will be again disassembled and it will again process for the formation of next vesicle. But those which are already uncoated, now they will reach to a particular target. In the target, you can observe T snares protein. But before reaching to the T snare protein, there is a tetering factor. This tetering factor will bind to the particular vesicles. Later on, what is going to happen? There is an interaction between V snare and T snare. Here, V snares are shown in the red color and T snares are shown in the dark blue and light blue color. This type of binding occurs. Due to this binding, now this vesicle will be able to bind with the acceptor region and vesicle will be fused, and finally you can observe that protein is already translocated. Such type of protein translocation will require snare protein. Now, I am just going to show certain peptides. As you know, all these things are required peptide. So, certain specific peptides has been shown here in a particular table. You should remember this because such type of signal sequences are already it is present everywhere, but these are in the competitive examination. So, it is just a compilation for preparation in competitive exam. See the first one, that is COP1. Such vesicles are always requires KDEL. Remember, those type of vesicle which are having KDEL type of sequence, it is indicating that it is ER resident protein. It means now such type of vesicle will translocate this particular protein from Golgi body to ER. In a simple way, you can understand that if ER resident protein will translocate to the Golgi, it will retrieve back due to this signal KDEL. Other such signal is known as KKXX, that is lysine, and 2X, it means to any other amino acid. These signals are also explaining that, or these are also showing that the COP1 vesicle will participate in retrieval of protein from Golgi body to ER. The other thing is COP2 vesicles, they are indicating enterograde direction, it means ER to Golgi. For that, it requires diacidic signal sequence. And fourth, for the clathrin, you should understand mannose-6-phosphate. This is one of the very important example. Mannose-6-phosphate is a specific signal molecule, and these are associated with only those protein which will be part of lysosome. It means the protein which need to be translocated in the endosome for the formation of lysosome, they must contain mannose-6-phosphate. Besides that, certain other signal molecule you should remember. To target in the ER, signal molecule must have 6 to 12 hydrophobic amino acid. What I am going to explain, you can understand in the co-translational pathway. I just told you in the previous slide that when protein synthesis initiated in the free ribosome and later on it need to be translocate on the ER for complete translocation, for complete synthesis of protein, that is co-translational pathway. In this case, the target sequence or the signal sequence will be 6 to 12 hydrophobic amino acid. Like in the same way, for target I can say for entry of protein into the mitochondrial matrix, the protein must requires amphiphatic helix, that is 20 to 25 residue with RK, whereas to entry of protein in the peroxisome must require some specific signal peptides, and that will be SKL, that is serine, lysine as well as leucine, And for the nucleus, just immediately in the last slide I have shown you that one cluster with the 5 basic amino acid or 2 smaller basic cluster must be required. So this is about the sorting signals, the signal peptides, and I hope you understand the 3 part. I just covered 3 part. First part is what is protein sorting, other part is what is different type of vesicle, and what are the signal peptides by which they can transfer and finally diffuse. So this is all about protein sorting, targeting, as well as signal peptides. Hope you understand well. Thank you.